Hi, Amper Man and Arix here, and we're taking a first look at Advanced Warfare's campaign mode. Now, recent Call of Duty games for me have all been about the multiplayer. That's where I spend the majority of my time. But I've heard really good things about the campaign mode this time around, and Alex has been delving into it, and he's going to take me through some of the really cool scenarios and tell me why I should really devote some time to this mode as well as multiplayer.
Yeah, I mean, like, I'm a massive fan of multiplayer, but I've always feel in Call of Duty's I'd kind of need to do the single player first. It's just sort of a tradition for me. I feel like, you know, you get used to the guns, you learn all the different abilities, and especially in this one, you know, this is, you've got the main core thing about Advanced Warfare is your exoskeleton. It completely changes the way you move, changes the gameplay. I mean, you've obviously experienced that in multiplayer as well. But in single player, you know, I found that it's an easier way for me to kind of, like,
this
jump
is the,
in.
This is the demo they showed at E3, yeah?
Yeah, level one. I mean, you know, you saw that I ripped that car door off, so obviously exoskeleton gives me strength, but also it gives me movement ability, so I'm kind of using this is my training ground. I mean, this is obviously
Matrix Revolution.
Yeah, exactly. But it's supposed to be, you know, semi-believable. It's set in like 2054, so it's not too far in the future. And some of these things are supposed to be based on, like, you know, sort of initial designs in like military tech and things like that. So, you know, you never know in the future. But this here is really, really cool. The grenade that lets you see, you know, through walls and whatnot. So that's definitely useful, and that's obviously useful in multiplayer.
Yeah,
as well.
Absolutely.
But the thing I like about campaign as well, there are some sort of like ways that the abilities are used that don't necessarily transfer to single player. You know, there are vehicles in here as well, but even the way that
what gun is that? That's cool.
That's the Bauer 27. This actually, it's got a sight and a silencer on it. I like this part here. I always really like this in campaigns. Like any game, like I'm a massive fan of stealth games. Like, I really like, sort of, you know, you saw the way that I kind of took them out in such an order so that no one actually saw them. Kind of went through that whole area trying not to be seen. I'm going to jump forward a little bit though, because I want to sort of like show you a few different sort of cool sections. So just now we were in Seoul, but right now we are in Lagos, and we're sort of like sneaking through this unmanned kind of stealth drone. So we're actually on the roof above, sort of like checking down and seeing what's in here, so we can sort of like check the lay of the land and find out when we're going to sort of
graphics are amazing.
Yeah,
really good.
It's so good this time around. But we're going to sort of jump off the top and kind of see. I mean, this.
What would you call this thing they're deploying here?
I'm going to call it a roof destruction device. Yeah, he's going to twist this, going to spin around, and this is, you know, you've seen these in Call of Duty.
An RDW.
Your standard. I like it. Your standard sort of breach scene. You know, you drop in, but I love these moments. You know, they might be cliche, but you know, I love it. You drop in slow motion, feel like Neo from the Matrix.
Yeah.
Taking them all out. So that is really cool. I think it's moments like these as well that, you know, if you had to jump straight into the multiplayer, you kind of just miss these. You know, I mean, I appreciate this. You know, this multiplayer will always be your bread and butter in Call of Duty. It's what you're going to spend most of your time in. You know, I will do the same. But I just think, you know, jumping straight into multiplayer, you're gonna miss out on some cool things like this. So this out here, I mean, I like this.
It's like sort of Terminator Frogger.
Yeah, I was about to say, it reminds me of kind of Frogger this bit. Do you want to watch out? I did actually kind of, I didn't show you the clip there, but I did actually get run over by the bus the first time around. But in this scene you're about to jump to, you'll recognise this as well from like one of the
one of the trailers, yeah?
Yeah, this is a really, really cool part. This also reminds me of, it's Matrix 2, yeah, when you're fighting on top of the buses.
That's right.
We're about to go in here and try and sort of survive while also taking all the different people out. But this again, you know, really cool use of the exosuit. And here, obviously, I've got like another ability. Another one of these ones that I said before doesn't necessarily transfer across the multiplayer. I've got like a magnetized glove. You can actually use it at certain parts in the campaign to climb walls as well. But you know, I'm here, obviously, hanging onto this bus. Took a couple of hours to, you know, you have to get your sort of timing right on some of these events. Some of them are quite brutal, you know.
I saw Andy got squashed.
quite a few times on that. But yeah, so sort of climbing up here. I'd quite like it if this sort of did transfer to multiplayer. But I appreciate, you know, you then have all the snipers just climbing the walls.
Okay, well I'll give it a go, but this weekend I'm still going to be a multiplayer.
So, all right.
If anybody wants a game, message me and off we'll go.